I'm sitting on the back terrace here at Rue, which is a fabulous inn in Provincetown. It's on Bradford Street. And I just finished a 3-day stay. I swear to God, I'm gonna move in. Not only because it's so gorgeous here, look at this, the greens, the browns, the yellows, the plants, the fruit, the vegetables, but the women who run the place, Allie and Eileen, they're the nicest, funnest, oh my God. I didn't know where to stay, so I was online looking at TripAdvisor. It's all 5-star reviews. So I go online to look at the website and I see these beautiful drawings. There are, they love art, they appreciate art. This place is covered in art. You can actually buy art right off the walls. I'm tempted to go out to try a restaurant out on Commercial Street, but I refuse to give up my breakfast here that Allie prepares with such care. Unbelievable. This morning I had some sort of Israeli, like, you know, egg over easy on this beet puree. I took my hand and I licked the plate. I licked it clean. And then I look forward to happy hour. So once I have breakfast, I'm like, meh, I'll maybe grab some lobster roll in town. It's not even gonna compare to the happy hour that they make right out of their garden. They made like a little pea shoot on top of a bruschetta with a cherry tomato. It's just cut right in half, a little salt on top, and a nice rosé. It was chilled in a fancy glass. You sit on the front porch, you watch the world go by. I'm gonna come back and come back and come back. They might end up having to get a restraining order. That's how much I love it here. So you better come. You're gonna love it too.
Hey everybody, welcome to episode 4 of Funny Food TV. We got a surprise for you today. We got this awesome chick, comedian, actress, Kelly Kinsella, all the way from New York City. And here she is.
Hi.
Kelly.
Michele, I'm so excited to be in your show.
I'm super excited to have you.
I just got here from the train station. Sir, I just brought all my stuff.
That's okay. You look fantastic.
Thank you so much.
You know this is a cooking show, right?
Oh, it's a cook. Oh, it's okay. Oh. Well, I should have known with all the cameras and everybody here. So yeah, I'm not
TV.
On stage.
No.
Okay, great.
Yeah,
great.
I mean, we're cooking some food today.
You look fantastic today.
Thanks, Michele.
Really beautiful. Is this what you do, though? Are you on stage?
Well, I do mostly stage shows. I mean, I'm a comedian, right? I do one-woman shows.
Yeah.
But oftentimes I'm invited to do other gigs, you know, Broadway gigs, and I just show up in this gown, and, you know, people go crazy.
I mean, I love it.
Thank you.
And everything, but
thanks.
This is a cooking show.
Oh, God, you're right.
Yeah.
It's a cooking. Well, at least, I mean...
No.
No? Okay.
Well, because you don't want food
okay.
getting stuck.
Well,
you're,
you know what? I'm so... I have to tell you the truth. I did bring some other things because I wasn't even really 100% on this. To tell
yeah,
you.
It's great.
I have
great.
A hard time I mean, making decisions. I have a hard
oh.
time making... But I... Okay. If you can help me out a little bit because, I mean, I don't have a stylist. You know, I'm
right.
not a television person. It's mostly stage.
Yep.
Everybody's like, okay.
I get it. Super
you
cool.
It?
And remember,
so,
we're in Cape Cod.
We're in
Cape...
Yeah. Oh, my
yeah,
God.
Right. It's beautiful
I'm so
there,
happy to...
Right?
I should relax a little bit. I have an anxiety disorder, so I write
a
shows.
A little nervous.
Well, a little bit. You
right.
know, I'm like, yeah, I'm on the TV. I don't know how to act. I don't know what to
That's
say.
Okay, not like that. Okay, we're gonna cook. It's gonna
okay,
be fun.
We're gonna cook. I love
yeah.
to cook.
Okay.
I don't know if you know this, but I love to cook.
Oh, great.
But
so you
now,
shouldn't be too hard.
Okay, should I cook in this hippie moon? Okay.
No.
Okay, I'm gonna
Remember,
put
we're,
them.
We're gonna get dirty a little bit.
Now you
down
might,
and dirty.
I'm gonna leave it there in case you
okay.
change your mind. Because I'm not the only crazy one here, Michele.
Oh! I might be a little feisty there.
All right, garden party.
No, if
I can
attending.
Put on an accent or something and I can talk like this.
Nope, we're cooking.
Okay.
Okay.
All right, listen, beach wrap. A little bikini, I've got a bikini.
It looks great with your eyes, but no bikini.
Okay.
We're cooking.
What are you saying, that I'm fat?
No, you look
okay.
I mean,
all right.
Yeah. If,
I am 40-something.
Oh,
I'm not going to say.
I am 40-something myself.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Well, you look good.
Thanks, you too.
Nice
Fine.
We got
no.
Okay. I thought
okay.
you said like,
I'm kind of glad you didn't wear or well, you had this outfit I saw you in on page 6 New York Post.
Oh, the New York
thought
Post.
Thought you were going to wear that.
I
yeah.
always, you know, I never thought that that was going to become what it became. I was invited to do like this modeling gig. You
mm-hmm.
know, a friend of mine is a well-known photographer, fashion photographer, and I was so excited. I showed up and, you know, thinking I was going to be wearing like a Prada pantsuit this
yeah.
whole time. And instead, they put me in a woman's vagina costume. So that's what she's talking about, everybody. I don't know if you've seen it. It was actually... It was all over the place. It was in the Daily News in Britain, and it was in some German newspaper. It was in some other, like, funky...
It went viral.
It went viral.
That's
yeah.
awesome.
Caught on.
No, but
real catchy. And then I was also seeing Cosmo.
Yeah, I saw it. It was a great spread.
Oh, why, thank you. You know a lot about spreads, Michele.
Do.
I You're a chef.
I mean, I am.
Actually, it wasn't just like a silly costume thing. It was actually for a really good cause. The company conceived in Brooklyn that makes these costumes, they paired up with a charity called 50 Cent Period. And these people are based in Georgia, and they actually raise funds to buy feminine hygiene products for women in third world countries who can't afford.
That's awesome.
You know, to pay for those things. So it's actually really, really great.
And so we'll let you wear that vagina costume.
Yeah,
yeah. Good causes for everything, right? We like to do them.
So. Yeah, exactly.
That's excellent.
Exactly. Yeah.
That's the one.
Oh,
so
good.
I think that you should get dressed.
I got more. Okay. No, all right. Good. Yeah. Yeah. I'll do. Okay. Great. I'm gonna. Yeah. I'll be right back.
Hurry up.
I'll be right back. Yeah.
Because we're cooking, right?
Yeah. I've got hats in there. If you want to wear a hat, just try the hats.
No hats.
I'll be right back, everybody. I promise I won't take too long.
I mean, hurry up. What do you think, you guys? I don't know. Who wears hats to a cooking show? I hope she hurries up. I don't know. Let's try this one on. She better hurry up. This is my fantastic beach look. I mean, all right, I think she's back. Let's get this on the road.
All right, sorry that took so long,
That's all right.
I had to get the belt on.
And great.
This is my chicken outfit.
I mean, you
this
look
is
ready.
What I, right?
Kind of Cape Cod.
It's kind of like what you do to make grilled chicken.
Yeah, you look good.
Or what you're
wearing. I'm excited to make grilled chicken because I'm always cooking fish or seafood.
Oh, fish, yeah.
Because we're in Provincetown. But
oh, we are in Provincetown. Cape Cod, we're like on the water.
Yeah, so.
This fresh sea air that I keep, this wind is so nice.
It's incredible,
I feel like I should, you know, that we're here, that we're on Cape Cod. I don't come here very often.
Uh-huh.
So I feel like, you know, I feel like I should probably be making fish. I mean, I'm feeling that maybe if it's not too late,
I
could maybe change my thing because I live in this tiny apartment and I never cook fish.
Right.
Because it always smells everything up. Yeah. And I kind of feel like we should be making fish.
Okay.
Is it good.
I actually have some lobsters.
You do?
So we're going to make a lobster roll.
Okay, good.
How's that?
You have lobsters
here? I have
here?
Them because, yeah, I live here. The pier's right there. I always have fish.
Oh, so it's local?
Yeah, of course.
From these waters?
Never use anything but local seafood.
Exactly.
Very important.
Yeah, I agree.
Listen, I have it, but that's it. That's what we're doing.
Okay. No,
right,
I promise.
Yeah.
Lobster rolls it is.
Lobster roll.
I love a lobster
roll.
Right,
I'm going to go get the everything.
Okay.
The stuff.
All right.
And we'll get it on.
Okay.
All right. We'll get it on. All right.
Thanks, Michele. Thanks for accommodating me. I'll just wait here.
You just wait
I'm going to smell the sea air. So I feel like I should probably change into maybe these espadrilles if I'm going to do the fish. Maybe I can I'll be a little lower. I'll be a little shorter. Maybe I'll do that. Okay. I'm going to change into the espadrille. This doesn't really match, but that's a stripe. It's a stripe. I like a nice espadrille because it reminds me of the beach and it's fishy and I wish I had a different color because it doesn't really match with this. I hope it's going to be okay. It's kind of clashing.
Hi.
Maybe I could change into these. Oh, hi. I was just worried about my outfit. This is not really a fish outfit. Are these guys alive?
I always happen to have cooked lobster around because I like to make lobster rolls.
Oh, you do?
You know, we have so much lobster and seafood around here that
How often do you make or eat at a lobster roll?
Every day.
Every day?
I mean, like, we literally at the Central House clean about 100 lobsters a day.
Really?
So we break them down. We get them fresh right off the docks. Lobster rolls all day long, lobster pop. We make a lot of things with lobster. So this I thought would be really easy for you. And since you are in New York you know, you can have a tiny apartment.
Yeah,
and
I can. So
tear
I can maybe
up a lobster roll.
Nice. And I can maybe boil it myself in a big pot.
Yeah, we don't boil.
Okay.
No, never boil. To me, never boil at home, you guys. Steam a lobster. Tiny bit of water. Doesn't get waterlogged. It stays really fresh, you know?
Okay, yeah.
Boiling lobsters,
good. Okay, good.
But today, I thought it would be pretty cool, since you're here,
that
we would make it smoky and throw it on the grill. What I do is I steam them for, 2 minutes, so they're raw inside, right?
Yeah.
And then we're just gonna pick up some of the smoke flavor from the grill, which would be really cool. We're gonna grill probably for about 4 minutes.
Are you gonna dip it in butter first?
No.
No.
No butter, because we're going. Oh, so okay, let's talk about this.
I want butter.
She's a crybaby. There's a bunch of different lobster rolls, right?
Yeah.
Everybody, like Connecticut, is butter and lemon.
Expensive.
I'm from there.
You're from there. Okay.
And then there's Maine and Massachusetts, which is always like mayonnaise.
Blue collar is like a little bit more like, get in there.
Yeah, it's more like hearty. I'll say hearty.
Okay.
It's a hearty lobster roll.
Yeah.
Right? So you get celery and sometimes herbs.
Yeah.
I put dill because I'm Greek and Italian.
This is Greek.
Greek Sicilian.
Oh, wow. Watch out. Yeah. Watch out, everybody. Hide the knives.
Be careful out there. Right, hide the knives. I thought that it would be really cool to give it a little smoky flavor, okay, and let's make our own lobster roll, right? We don't have to be like everybody else.
So that's just like a whole new thing, or is this something you're...
It's my thing.
That's your
it's
thing.
It's our thing now.
It's our thing. Oh, my
yeah,
God.
We're doing it together.
I got my own lobster roll.
Yeah, so we're going to like... Yeah, this is your own lobster roll.
Can I take one to go? Can I have one here and one to go?
Yeah, okay. I got three rolls.
Okay, you can have one.
Well, I think we're going to get to cooking. We're going to turn this grill on.
Okay.
And then I'm going to explain to you exactly what we're going to do. I'm going to show you how to throw down some seafood, lady. We're going to turn this guy
on. How can I help you here?
I'd back up.
Okay. There we go.
Okay, so let's switch spots, and I'm going to show you.
Yeah, because I don't know how to crack that guy open.
Well, that's part of this whole thing. So we're going to make this really simple. I don't like to muddle flavors together. Five or six things, put them together. Yeah. At home, when you guys are like cooking and throwing things together, my favorite thing is to keep it really simple. Like, if you're using lobster, use four other things and that's it. You want the lobster to shine and whatever else, and fresh herbs. Again, you guys, always fresh herbs. I agree.
I like fresh herbs too. I have some little herbs gardens out on my fire escape, so I can, those are easy to grow in the window. Yeah.
And then you pick them and use them, right? Because it makes your food, I think it makes your food more exciting when you're cooking at home. There's something about growing your own food and then using it. If for instance, you have people over, you make a pizza. Mm-hmm. You go outside, you pick the basil, and you put the basil on the pizza, right?
Yeah.
And then you feed your friends, and you're like, this is the best pizza in the world. Because it was your herbs. And you're like, they're my herbs. You know what I'm saying? All right, so we got this guy, right?
Yeah.
Two minutes, I cooked him.
Look at him.
He's pretty, right?
He looks like a
All we're doing is getting smoke on this guy, right? We're going to get some flame.
Oh, so you're not going to peel it first. You're going
to we're going to peel it after.
Okay.
And, again, for the home cook and for you, since you know how to cook, if you have lobster shells, shrimp shells, they make wonderful stock. So you guys, like, literally take the shells, don't throw them out. Put them in a pot with some water and then freeze it. You can make a sauce if you want lobster fra diablo. There you go. You got lobster stock. Put it in an ice cube tray or something.
Okay.
I mean, it really is...
All right.
You know, us chefs, we're pretty cool.
Yeah, yeah.
We got some stuff going on.
You got some tricks of the trade up your sleeve, up your little flannel sleeve.
That's right. I do. I'm dressed for it today, right?
So you don't close this?
No.
Okay.
I mean, we can close it, but it looks pretty, right? We're just getting color.
All right,
here's what we're going to do now. We're going to get rid of this guy.
Okay.
I love your shoes.
Thank you. They don't
match. They're not cut at all, but whatever.
Okay.
So look, we got some celery. Okay. It's finely diced. Pretty small, right?
Because
you want crunch. Mm-hmm. I always say that there's like five things that should happen to a lobster roll. So there's crunch from the bun, because you want it to be buttery and crunchy.
Mm-hmm.
And then there's steam. You should get the steam in that piping hot soft.
Yeah.
Then you get the lusciousness. Oh, I know, right? Like sexy.
Yeah.
From the lobster. Then you get the creaminess of the mayonnaise. And then you get the crunch from the celery. Was that five? I think that was five.
That was five. But you don't want too much mayonnaise. That's the key.
Well, right.
And I love the colors, like the pink, this kind of orangey pink, and then the greens on top. And
well, this is just because we cooked these guys.
Yeah.
All right, so now I got some chives.
Okay.
Okay, because we want a little onion.
Yeah.
So we're going to
go too overboard on that, right?
No,
I always add more. I always add more of, like, spices.
Right,
like
so
a recipe will say a teaspoon of something. I'm always like, two, three.
Yeah, so you're not a recipe follower.
Not a recipe follower.
I'm not either, but for you guys at home, follow recipes if you feel uncomfortable. If not, I mean, to me, it's like kitchen's your playground. Go for it.
Who thought of this? Who thought of, like, green and pink? Like, who makes these decisions in the world?
Well, I mean, I don't know. I don't know. I think chefs, like, we, you know, everything is like our senses. Sight, sound, smell.
So intuition.
Taste, yeah.
So I feel like I was born without an intuition.
You do?
I do. Like, I have a hard time, like, committing... making a decision, like, okay, I want to go back to the chicken right now.
Well, no, we're, no, nope. we're staying on this.
Okay, all
okay,
right.
So you're a little indecisive. You don't know what's going on, but look.
Well, look at, like,
this should get you excited, right?
Oh, look, they're like sunning themselves.
Yeah, so, they're cooking, they're doing their thing, and we're going to do our thing right here.
Okay, good, let's do it.
All right, so, celery.
So, celery.
Small dice. And then we have some chives.
Okay. Not too much.
No. We're going to go small, and then we can add. Always go small, put a little bit in, and then you can always add again at the end.
All right.
Okay?
Well, that makes
sense.
So, you'll just know to add.
Yeah, I'm kind of spectacular that way.
See, I
just
like
have really good.
I like that about you. You're like a woman who knows what she wants.
100%. Are you? No, you're not. You're a little confused.
Nah, sometimes I do. Like, I want to know that is like a local dill. Is that local?
Yeah, it's local. Everything's local.
Everything's local.
So I personally, as a chef, do not like to use anything that's not local and not within at least, say, 100 miles. And I mean, there are some things, but these guys are right out there.
I was driving with my boyfriend, and we drive by these stands, and I'm like, stop here, let's get some of these, you know, and he's like, no, he just wants to get the destination. But I'm the person that wants to stop at every stand and pick, you know, touch the fruits, buy it. I want to stop at the corn stand. I want to stop at the peach stand. I want to stop at the tomato stand. I'll just stop. And, you know, it'll take me like 18 hours to get here. I don't care. Like, I want that stuff. It like makes me feel good about myself. What is this?
So this is dill.
Dill.
Nobody puts dill in their lobster roll.
Why?
I do. I mean, I love it. I love the smell of it. It's my favorite herb. Yeah.
Can I smell,
it? Taste it. Feel it. Play with it. Eat it, play with your food.
I love the feel of it. It's like it's like a bed of moss. I want to take a nap on it.
Okay, well.
Maybe after the show.
We need a lot of dill for you to take a nap, but if you want, you can do whatever you want. You're a province town. You could do anything you want.
Right. I might even change my clothes again.
But not in the show, you're not going to.
I feel like the nautical might kind of work at this point. No?
No.
Can we put some clothes on these guys?
I mean, no. No, we can't, but we're almost going to be ready to break these apart.
I know. When are they going to be ready?
I mean,
you just touched that? Like, you're,
wow, did you see that?
Yes, I saw that. Are you okay?
Yeah, this is what cooking's all about, right? So, yeah, I can pull these apart, and I'm going to teach you how to do it. I think we'll do one and leave one guy on there and see what we're looking like. Do you want me to shut this? You seem nervous.
I feel like I'm hot.
Yeah.
It's like a little warm, but that's, I'm nervous because I feel the tension. I want to put my hands on the grill.
Right, you talk like, really fast. You're making me a little nervous.
She's
making me nervous.
Aren't you warm with the flannel?
No, I feel great. I mean, I live here. I like flannels. It's kind of part of my, it's my thing. It's my look.
I like the ensemble.
The look. Okay.
But these guys, I know it's not warm, this shell.
No, touch it. I won't burn you.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
All right, so I'm going to shut this. So have you ever broken a lobster apart with your hands?
No, but I'll do it right now. Give it to me and I'll smash it on the freaking cement floor.
Okay.
I have so much anger inside.
I see it in your face a little bit.
Well, I mean, I hear not so much. Since I've come here with the air and the fresh air, I feel good. I feel relaxed. But I mean, get me back to New York and I'll put that in my suitcase and I'll snap it in two as soon as I get off the train.
Okay. I lived there for 8 years, so I understand.
Oh, you do? Okay.
Yeah,
oh, you
I did.
In Brooklyn?
Yeah.
Okay.
Now I'm here, so it's excellent.
Oh, good for
you. I'm going to show you the first one.
Yeah.
Super easy. Watch, okay? This little guy.
Yeah. Oh, my God.
We're
that
do
was
that.
So easy.
Right. It's really easy, right?
Okay.
And then we're going to go like this.
Yeah, I like the sound of that.
Right?
Yeah.
Okay, you want to squeeze that so then you can just kind of like, I don't want you to hurt your dainty.
Then you just
self.
Like, no, I got
okay,
to get in there.
See how good that is?
And there's the poop.
All right, well, it's not
Let's
really.
Get that poop out of there.
It's like, a little bit, but we're going to take this. Okay. We're going to clean it up. I got a little towel here. We're cooking outside.
I feel like from this angle, my arms look fat. Do you think I can maybe just wear something? Can I put maybe your
No.
Are you sure? I don't look.
No,
fat.
You look good, and we're not changing.
No. How about I do this? I'm going to pose like this. I'm just going to, watch while you do that. Like this, so I look skinny.
Okay.
It's the camera stuff.
I mean, you look great.
Thank you.
All right, you look fantastic.
The hat, I feel a little unprepared.
We're cooking.
Okay, good.
All right, ready? So we got this and this.
Yes.
Okay, we got two parts.
Yeah.
Now we're gonna take these guys, right?
Yeah.
All right, we're just gonna take them and get this out of
here. Rip their arms right off.
Right.
That's nice. Well, somebody else is pretty angry too, Ronnie. I'm happy. I live in Provincetown, and so my life is perfect. My name is Michele Ragussis. I have my own restaurant. I have a house that has dill in it. Well, I live in a one-room apartment in New York City. My life sucks. But go on. I'm skinny now.
Turn around. We're cooking. No.
Okay.
Towards me. Oh. Yo, lady, come back to me.
Sorry, right. I was outside me with this camera.
You want to learn?
I do want to learn.
You're crazy. She's crazy.
I'm learning.
Okay.
Oh, my God. I just rested.
Yeah, don't do that. You might want to step back a little bit.
No, I'm good.
Remember, we're making lobster.
I'm just like,
turn towards
I'm
me.
Sit on this.
I'm going to teach you.
Okay.
I'm teaching.
Okay,
come back
button this button.
If you want to. Anybody can
unbutton
their
clothes. I feel like, you know, that
clothes.
Way it's a little more sexy. I know it's daytime, but, you know, okay.
Right, because we're in province.
Yeah, we're in province.
Sexy. Yeah. Sexy in province.
Okay, good.
Okay, look, so we're going to take this guy out.
Okay.
Right, see that?
Yeah.
We don't.
That's messy.
All right, so now we're going to take, this is really awesome what we're doing right now.
Now those juices, if you broke that over a dish, could you have saved the juice?
Well, you don't want the lobster roll to be too wet. Yep,
oh my
here's
God,
what we're going
to
do. You ready?
Yes.
You're going to get to do it.
Oh. But the other side, not the sharp side. Yep.
Just like that. Look at this. Right
now,
out.
Is this like an egg where sometimes an eggshell gets in like an egg salad and the tongue gets slit and then you go to the emergency. I heard the story where somebody ate egg salad and the eggshell got in their tongue and it slid up on their tongue and they had a bit stitches.
Okay, I don't know, but not, it's not happening in my kitchen.
All right, okay.
Okay, look, no shells.
Oh my God.
Beautiful,
perfect.
Right?
All right. I just want to eat it now.
So I'm going to let you really soon. All right, so look, then we take these guys. Yeah. And these you got to be careful with, right? Because they hurt. But this is my favorite part. You stick your finger right in there and pop it out.
And then you can make, this can be like a ring. Look at, then you can, this can be like a ring. Or like a, you know, like a.
I mean, you can wear it all day.
You can do like this. You get in there.
You can pick your nose. This is a cooking show.
It smells, yeah. It smells good.
We're cooking.
Okay.
All right. Back to the cooking. Bring it back. All right. So I'm going to let you do this one because I just taught you how to do it, right? It's a little bit messy.
Yeah.
Thank God you're not wearing that cap.
I know, right?
Holy, you'd be a mess.
I've gotten all over my décolletage.
Décolletage. Okay, go ahead. Ready?
So I pull this.
Yeah. Oh, good. Look, on the first time. Not everybody does that.
Oh, really?
You always want this piece to be out of the lobster. It's really important or someone's going to get.
Oh,
like,
really?
You know,
yeah. Oh, so this is like dangerous. Right. That's dangerous.
Okay. So now.
Speaking of danger, can I use the knife?
Yes, ma'am. But you got to use it backside.
Okay.
Not.
Okay, backside, not blade side.
And I'm gonna cut them. Tap it right about there. You gotta hold it.
Okay, I gotta hold it. All right, so can I come over here?
Yeah.
That way, now I'm gonna move this here.
Yep.
And I'm gonna do.
Harder. I thought you were angry.
I am angry, but then if I get really angry, I'm gonna reach up really high and I'm gonna slice my face.
Here, go this side. New York City anger.
Okay.
One,
two, three.
Yeah.
Oh my God. I was
scared. Look at how perfect. Look at that. See, you just did it so right. The whole thing's going to come right up.
Oh my God. It's perfect.
Look at how beautiful. One shell.
It's perfect.
Yeah.
Okay.
Now, this is where this gets easy and fun.
All right.
Can I open this again?
Yes, please do.
Are you going to be crazy?
No, because I'm going to lean on it and then I'm going to burn myself.
Right. We're going to leave this guy for a while, right? Because right now, I'm going to put this together for you. So, the one good thing that you always need is a good bun, right?
Okay. Yeah. You are an Italian.
A brioche bun.
Okay, so the brioche is all the rage these days.
Yeah, well,
like everything's
buttery.
On a brioche, right?
Right, so it's really buttery and delicious. Mm-hmm. And in New England, we use, you know, when you make lobster rolls, they're always like the split top hot dog buns.
Okay.
So I bought ones that weren't, but I'm gonna do it myself. So we got this beautiful roll.
So this is kind of like a standard New England thing.
New England lobster rolls, always a split top bun, always
I've never seen these.
Hot doggy.
Okay, but will you put a hot dog in there too? Or you can?
You can if you want. You can have a hot dog lobster roll, but we're not doing that.
Okay. Wouldn't that be weird? That would be something.
So
that would
all we're going to do is put some butter on this guy, just like that.
Nice.
Right?
Ooh.
Each side.
She's getting there with her fingers.
Yeah.
Did you clean your hands?
So we got this roll buttered, right?
Okay.
And remember I said in the beginning, it's really important to have a crunchy outside.
Yeah, it's a nice crunchy outside.
Soft.
Oh my God. Was this the whole time like this? I'm sorry. So I feel like I need to button this up. I can't believe, was this showing the whole time? And you didn't tell me, Michelle?
I didn't see it.
Oh yeah, right. Right, Michelle.
I did not see it.
She was focused on her lobster.
All right. So here's what we're going to do.
See how I keep wanting
We got this lobster meat. We want to keep this. So what we're going to do is just, this is where we're going to put this whole thing together.
Okay.
So I'm going to get rid of all this.
Oh,
we're going to build a lobster roll. Here's what we're going to do.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to chop this lobster meat just like this. You want to leave it in big chunks, right? Because look how beautiful it is. Right?
Oh, you leave the big chunks.
Yeah, we want this. When you're eating a lobster roll, you want to know you're eating a lobster roll, right?
Yeah.
I want to get rid of that guy. We're going to salt it a little bit, but remember, lobster's salty, and it's, you know, comes from the ocean, so watch when you're salting seafood. You really have to be delicate with it.
All right. Oh, that's the mayonnaise. Is this Hellman's? What kind of mayonnaise
sometimes,
do you use?
Usually at my place where I work, we make our own.
You do?
So, which is just eggs and oil and a little vinegar and some lemon.
Yeah.
But today, I thought I'd make it easy for you.
Okay.
Okay? And now we're going to mix it.
Look at that.
Right? This is all we want to do.
And you didn't measure the mayo. Yeah. You just kind of went with it. She was using her intuition, everybody.
So
she got
really
intuition.
Dilly. It's
right.
Really herby.
Oh my God!
I like this.
Nice.
Lots of crunch because I like that.
Yeah.
Right.
I love all the green in there.
Right. It's really colorful. And now we're gonna put it together.
Can you tell me where your intuition comes from? I might be able to learn something from you today, except for cooking. Just like how do you know
when you're life you're, intuition?
You're like decision, and you go with it. Yeah. Your intuition. Where do you in your body? Where do you feel it?
I feel it in my stomach.
In your stomach?
Yeah.
Okay.
In my gut. I get a gut and it's food, right?
Yeah.
So you get this, I just get a gut feeling. If I want to do something, I do it. If I don't, I don't. Mm-hmm. For all you people out there, just do what you want to do. That's what life's about.
Okay. All right. I'm going to move here.
You should move here because it does something special.
Okay.
You know?
I'm going to try to do my shows here is what I'm going to do. I'm going to come back next summer. I'm going to do my show.
What exactly is your show?
Well, I got a bunch of shows.
Okay.
I actually do a bunch of different one-woman shows.
Yeah.
And the one that I've been doing recently that people are really responding to is called When Thoughts Attack.
Okay.
And it's about anxiety. It's about a woman who can't make a decision. Quelle surprise. Oh, mon Dieu.
That's you.
There's a little French in there, too. It's funny. People like it because it reminds them of themselves. No one wants to admit that they have anxiety and they can't get through life.
Thank
you.
It.
the people who do admit it, like, they love the show.
That's awesome.
Yeah. So, yeah, it's kind of like, it's like Lily Tomlin-y kind of stuff.
This is it. This is what we want. I want you to just feel how nice and, like, warm. Right? And look at how nice that is.
Yeah.
So now we're going to fill this guy. And this is the fun part, right?
Yeah.
Of, like, making everything is just...
Are you going to put that all in there?
Yep.
Yeah, so like, what's the appropriate amount of stuffing to the buns?
I mean, I would use one lobster to a roll. That's the way I look at it. That's what we do at the Central House. It's about 5 ounces in a lobster when you take it all out.
Oh, my God.
So, right? And you kind of want to use your hands. We're at a barbecue. We get messy. We can use that. And then we put it all in there.
Oh, my God.
We'll stick it in there because I like to use my hands.
Yeah.
And this is for
This is for me, and so I get to eat this.
You get to eat
You guys, look at how beautiful this is. I'm going to show you that lobster roll. You know, I feel like I actually have an eating lobster roll outfit that I like to wear. This I'm not going to wear. This is not right. This is for cooking. This was supposed to be for cooking a chicken. But then I wasn't allowed to change into something different. But I, if you don't mind, I just want to really quickly, you can take a bite. I'll let you take a bite and then I'll be right back. I'll be right back, I promise. No, I'm going to be, it's just like, I swear to God, because I don't want to lose the heat on that bun. I don't want that bun to lose its heat. I'll be right back, you guys. I'm just going to change real quick.
Well, I lost her. Is she coming back for this? Look at this thing. Lobster, chives, dill, mayonnaise. It's fantastic. I mean...
Hi, Michelle. I'm back. Oh, I got on my lobster eating outfit.
My God, right? You're a vagina.
I'm a vagina. Well, I am more than a vagina because I'm just... Look. Hold that up.
Do
look
I feed
next
you?
To me. It's the same thing. I feel like I match my dinner.
I mean, I'm so excited what's the cause?
Is it still warm?
What's the cause?
Is it still soft?
It's warm and soft.
Okay.
It's warm and soft. You're not getting me in that thing.
All right. Okay.
I'm just saying.
Why you would think I'm here to eat this. I'm here to eat this. Okay, the cause is 50 Cent Period is the name of the organization, the charity.
Yeah.
And conceived in Brooklyn as people who make the costumes.
We will check
so
that
if you,
out.
So if you check it out on the website. In the meantime, I'm going to get into this because this is getting, this is cooling off.
Take a bite, vagina.
Take a bite. I'm going to do that.
Mm-hmm.
That's a chunk. I got a chunk.
That's a chunk of lobster. A lobster.
Oh my God. Are you sure you don't want to try this?
Oh, have a bite? You got some schmutz.
I got some schmutz. You know, you can't eat this without putting this on.
You love it.
So good. I just wish that you would put the costume on so you could have a bite.
Never putting the costume on.
All right. Simmer down now. I don't know why you think I'd force you into this costume.
Really?
Keep your smiles going and don't forget you're going to open your shoulders, everybody. Yep. And don't look at me. Look at each other. We're going to tell her how she's going to do her lobster.
It's hard to keep these boobies out.
Oh.
That was a blooper.